Say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? In the home of the brave.
And that was our national anthem performed by the talented Skylar Cole. And with that, we'll be right back in just a moment.
What you know about rolling down in the deep? When your brain goes numb, you can call that mental freeze. When these people talk too much, put that thing in slow motion. Yeah, I feel like an astronaut in the ocean. Ay, what you know about rolling down in the deep? When your brain goes numb, you can call that mental freeze. When what you know about rolling?
Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for this NBA presentation. In this game, we'll see the Atlanta Hawks going up against the Philadelphia 76ers here in Wells Fargo Center. With Brett Bailey and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge will be joining us on the sideline as well. DA, it's all yours.
Thanks very much. Well, Clint Capella is the modern day, old school game. Coach Nate McMillan said, we're taking advantage of these teams who play small ball. His ability to defend the basket and cover up mistakes, rebound the ball, set screens and roll, he's a threat on both ends of the floor. Kevin, some things never get old.
Indeed, thanks, T.A. Always fun to be on the call for one of these games, Brent. Conference rivals going at it. So much emotion. Teams that are very familiar with each other.
I love it, Kevin, and I'm so happy to be here with you for this one. This is going to be awesome. You don't get a lot of games like this so hype where the crowd is really into it, so let's move up a little bit and sit on the edge of our seat, should we?
Oh, look at Atlanta's opening lineup. Is the shooting guard, Hunter the small forward. Collins and Capella man the post positions. And it's Young and Ibaka. And for Philadelphia, front quarter Stiebel and Harris. Maxey out there with Harden. And it's Bassey in at the five down low. Now here's Murray. Passes it to Young.
Screen coming.
To the inside. And then Collins finds it in.
The dunker this guy is. Collins capable of bringing this crowd out of their seats.
from 3-point range. Now Murray. You saw him with 29 points last game. Capella with a screen on Maxey. 11 feet away. Murray, no good. And it's Maxey with the ball for the 76ers. Smash to Harden, puts one up for 19. Out to Harris, 3-pointer. Now in the scoring column with that bucket, 1-for-2 this game.
Working tirelessly on the stroke, Tobias Harris trying to find consistency with that shot.
Down low, the kick out to Young. Pass to Murray. 6 on the shot clock. It's hauled in by the 76ers.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
The shot's good.
And arguably no one in the NBA draws more attention than Harden. Part of why I think he creates so many opportunities for others.
Now, here's Capella. A look at his stats, he averages a bit over 8 points a game. Young for 3, as he pulls it in. And he's got 4 rebounds in this game.
Such a young roster, the Hawks exceeded expectations in that 21 season. They finished as the 5th seed. Eastern Conference then.
Hunter against Harden. Two free throws coming up and they call the shooting foul. Yeah, and many were shot when Atlanta, Brent, made it all the way to the Eastern Conference Finals in 2021.
Yeah, how about that, Kevin? So much just came together and really accelerated their competitive timeline. You just can't get ahead of that, though. You gotta take things step at a time, and their core players are still intact, and I think this team is poised to return to that kind of competitive level this year.
The first one falls.
And the playmaking of Harden continues to impress. Whether he's looking for his shot or creating for others, such a dynamic talent.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. And Greg Harden in recent years dealing with hamstring injury. Has he lost a step to age or injury?
Well, probably a little of both, but we've seen players with a new diet or is right now averaging 27 points a game. 6 to shoot. To the middle. Beautiful dash, and the layup goes down.
But you gotta take some chances, and young world do that, challenging the defense that time.
And there's the pass to Fiber. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. Back to Harden. Harden draws the double. Missed inside.
Well, for him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Young with the ball. Now, here's Hunter. A miss that time would have put him up.
That's not going to make you a favorite target of your teammates. They'll think twice about feeding you if you're going to keep missing layups. It's almost as if there's a lid on the hoop for him right now. Still hasn't gotten one to fall.
Murray dishes to Capella, passes it to Collins. Over Maxey, and there's Collins on the assist from Capella. Collins has got a second bucket tonight.
Well, Capella at that size really has no issues spotting the open man.
Harden the pass to Maxey. Here's Maxey. No good. And they can't put an end to this drought. Action on 50% from the field at this point, 4 of 8. From the baseline. No good on the shot. So Philadelphia will take it the other way. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
And that was one of those winning wins. I mean, they struggled in a lot of areas, but the fight was never in doubt. And that's one reason why they were able to pull it out.
Al Young, following Tobias Harris's three-point attempt. And here's Young. Popped up there for Collins. An emphatic alley-oop jam.
Man, so impressive. Collins way up for that one. They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
And the 76ers decide to take their first timeout here.
out east in the early season. You take a look at the 76ers. They've got the number one record in the conference, and because of it, each night out, their competition is going to bring it right at them. And, of course, the Atlanta Hawks, a few slots below them.
And I think for the Hawks, they've fulfilled a lot of the promise they showed coming into the season. But they just haven't taken that next leap forward so many thought they might. They still had enough players take positive steps forward to call this season a success. And they're not at the top of the standings where they hope they'd be. They're in a really good position in terms of the playoff picture.
Here's Bash. No points in the game yet for him. Maxi Bash is the fighter. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here. And look now at a few years worth of debt. Some of the assist numbers under the microscope for James Harden.
The drop in his assists over the past few years have made him more of a one-dimensional player offensively. He needs to get that passing element back in his game, and that'll make life a lot more difficult for opposing defense.
Now he's Harden. In the game against Orlando, very impressive.
If he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Here's Young. As he pulls it in. Got 6 rebounds here tonight. Outside Maxi. Harden up top. 18 footers right in the mark.
We're so used to seeing Harden pull up after dribble, but he's not going to turn down a chance off that catch and shoot jumper if it's there.
Now, here's Collins. He's got 6. Young with the ball. Licked up by Harris. Puts the move on. Young, no good.
A lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup.
Here is Harden. Some stats for him. He averages over 21 points a game. First contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
Gets one to fall, but only a second make in the first 7 attempts.
And now, Greg, that we're into the meat of the season, are you seeing any emerging trends out there?
For a few years, the trend had been guys shooting from farther and farther out. But, Kevin, I think we're seeing a return of the big man, a more concerted effort to attack the interior.
And the Hawks making a change here. Frank Kaminsky, he's checked in for Clint Capella. Okongwu comes in for John Collins. Johnson, he's checked in for Hunter. And Aaron Holiday is subbed in for Murray. The throw good, James Harden. And Greg, the Philadelphia 76ers have made it very clear that they are all in on a title run.
And their front office has been very focused on trying to get top-tier talent on this roster. They have to trust the process here. They're now aggressively pursuing titles here in Philly.
points in the paint. The defense, nowhere to be found. Harden the pass to Milton. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game. He's scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside. Young against Harden. Johnson sends the screen for Young. Over Harden. Almost, but it rolls out. This has not been a good quarter right here. Shot has been off the mark, and now it looks, Kevin, like he's pressing a bit. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Milton passes to Tucker. It's stolen by Kaminsky. Young against Milton. Young outside. Johnson with a screen on Milton. Here's Young. Kicks it out to Johnson. Clock at 4. Holiday with the 3. 1 up, 1 down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Here's Milton. He'll bring it up for Philadelphia. They trail by 1. Pass to Harris. He feeds it to Tucker. Two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. And since Tobias Harris got his big contract with the Sixers, Greg, some say they chose him over Jimmy Butler.
And while Tobias is nice, he's never been an all-star. And that's one of the few downsides to a big payday. Some might say he's overpaid. I'm sure he'll take the trade-off.
That's good from Harris. And this offensive system, Brett, that the Hawks run, it allows for a lot of creativity.
Yeah, lots of dribble handoffs at the top of the key. You obviously have the, in case of emergency, break glass player in Trae Young. But they're not afraid to attack mismatches, and this is the type of offenses that I think a lot of players enjoy playing. And some added toughness on the roster. Something Philly knew they needed after last year's playoffs. The hope is adding scrappy veterans like PJ Tucker and DeAnthony Melton will help them further.
A lot of give and take between these sides early.
And both teams look like they came to play.
And Philadelphia calls time here. Trae Young. Over the last month, he has been spectacular. And his playmaking ability, unquestioned, one of the top 15 assist men in our league. And yeah, one of the most dangerous scorers in the game. He's already come up big in some key games this year. His teammates really feed off his presence, I think. Pass to Melton. That one. So Atlanta will take it the other way. We're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of Miami. A game they definitely felt they could win. And with the break here or there, they probably could have. Maybe should have. The score doesn't indicate just how well they competed in that game for the majority of it. Looked like the better team. There's Melton. After the basket by Onyeka Okongwu. Harris bounce pass. Here's Tucker. And he hits the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Greg Kaminsky picks one up. Hey, gee, what about these Hawks? They can really be fun to watch. Yeah, they just need to be more consistent, Kevin. It seems they can beat anyone on any day. If they can start doing that regularly, we're talking about great things in the future. Two shots. Free throw, no good. And certain teams take on the attitude of their city. And over the years, Philadelphia has been one of them. The Sixers, known for having tough teams, much like the town. He's off on the second. And Greg, you mentioned the 76ers have taken on the entire Philadelphia. In your estimation, how? You know, you go all the way back to the 80s. This has been a team that plays hard, focuses on defense, and gritty. Much like their city. So they tend to play with a chip on their shoulder. There's Melton. Frank Kaminsky making his last shot. Melton the pass to Melton. There's Kurt Miles. Another miss by Philadelphia. The D doesn't seem to be too worried about him from three-point range, and he shows us why still. I expect him to make one of those. Now here's Holiday. And Okongwu has it in the corner. Down to five on the shot clock. That time. That's his first foul.
Yeah, way to get there first and be willing to absorb the contact.
The 76ers trail by five. Now Melton. 9-point game is last outing. Passes to Tucker. Fires the three. And
by the Hawks. The Minskys got 4 rebounds in this game. And Holiday kicks to Kaminsky. Okongwu with the screen for Holiday. It's over Melton. And there's Okongwu. That's good on the assist by Holiday. And now a 7-point Hawks lead. Now here's Melton, defended by Young. To Tucker. They need this one. A rebound by Young.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Okongwu, the pass to Young. Kaminsky sets the pick for Young. And he can extend the lead to double digits. Releases. And he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And so it's the Atlanta Hawks heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. Their defense has been active and effective. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. This is how the floor looks for the Hawks starting the second quarter. Two great spots filled by Hunter and Collin. Then goes to Jacque Moore. Then it's Clint Capella. And it's Holiday and at the point guard position.
And battling hard on the glass, they hold the advantage here so far.
Hunter, the pass to Collins. Over Maxey. Again, the Hawks score.
From the middle, part of Collins' game that is developing. Nice work, and that's paying off.
Pass to Bassey. Milton with the ball. Let's it go with a three. And it's held in by Clint Capella.
Don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Here's Murray. As he pulls it in. And he's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Shoots off the step back. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
Holiday looking for an opening. A steal. Maxey with it. Guarded by Murray. Up top, Maxey.
He's coming off a 16-point game against Orlando. Melton finds Maxi. And slam dunk by Maxi.
Excellent. Both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam tapped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. I have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
Finds himself wide open and drills it. And that's now 6 points for Tyrese Maxey. The Hawks win by 5.
And NBA All-Defense continues running. Matisse Thybulle has been a game-changing defender. From the minute he set foot in the NBA.
Let's check in with our reporter, David Aldrin.
Thanks very much. Now, some people call John Collins John the Baptist for how he dunks over defenders. He says, the game is slowing down for me. I'm able to see my spots. I want to continue to build on that and be looked at as a pillar, a guy that can be counted on. Devin, it seems, is a beautiful boy.
He's a big-time dunker, that's for sure, looking to reach his full potential. David, thanks. Things really clicking for him at the offensive end.
They're making good decisions, he's not wasting these opportunities.
And great, we know at Washington, Thybulle is the college defensive player of the year, averaging 3.5 steals, and over 2 blocks a game.
And for minute, not far off that pace in the pros. His opponent field goal percentage last season hit for second best in the league.
Take a break. Too soft.
That one is off. You know, it seems like we're seeing more teams, Brent, use zone defense these days. Not too long ago, zone was almost non-existent in the league.
Well, Kevin, you couldn't play zone, even though there were zone principles in man-to-man defense. It used to be an illegal defense to set up in a 2-3 zone that you see teams doing nowadays. I'm very interested if the league does, in fact, do away with illegal defense and allow coaches to use whatever defensive scheme they need to do to slow up their opposition. It might do something in terms of producing more shots so we don't get stagnation with just threes all the time. We'll see if that happens.
And now, the first timeout called here for the Hawks.
chance to look at stats for James Harden. This last month, he's been positively spectacular, averaging 22 points per, 6 assists and 4 rebounds. And so much of what they do on offense depends on how he plays. But he attracts serious attention from the defense, and that really does open up the backside for a lot of his teammates to take full advantage.
And so it's Murray with it. He brings it up for the Atlanta Hawks. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Back to Capella. And the dunk by Capella.
And you could tell Hunter knew he was open, did not hesitate to find him.
The 76ers trail by 4. Here's Max. 9 points in the game so far. Feeds to Hunter. Get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. This is his 3rd trip to the free throw line in the game. And the first one at the line is good. Harden hits them both.
At this point, you might as well go ahead and chalk up the points when he's at the free throw line. Pretty much automatic.
The pass to Capella. Murray with the bounce pass. And the dunk by Capella.
And that's where you want to feed Clint Capella deep down on the interior part of the paint and power through.
Now, here's Thibault. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. That one good for 2.
Great job of scoring. Nice job of taking to the rim. And get the finish.
Pass to Capella. Murray outside. Hot pass to Capella. Hammers the alley-oop through.
I draw that one up again. Throw it up. Capella jump. You slam it through. That's an easy 2.
Pass to Fiber. The Maxi, just 5 on the clock. From 17 feet out, that one no good. And Atlanta will come the other way. Their last meeting was in Philadelphia, where they were unable to fight off the 76ers.
Yeah, they came into that game a little flat. For whatever reason, and just couldn't tap into the energy we need to compete. Yeah, and that
score got a little bit lopsided, so not the kind of effort that they want to repeat anytime soon.
He's 2 for 2.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
Harden the pass to fight. And DeJounte Murray gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
And the next one puts him in the bank.
Maxi kicks the thigh ball. Good ball mover here by the 76ers. Shot clock at 6. From 14, Harden, no good.
Another rebound hold in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of pressure.
Harden, the pass to Silver. Murray, this is the holiday.
So far this season, the fourth spot held by the Hawks.
You know, it's not necessarily a glamour stat, but make no mistake, their top-notch board work has been a huge key to their success.
Now here's Holiday. 10-point lead, this is their biggest. Capella with a screen on heart. God bash to Capella. Up high to stop the alley-oop.
This might be one of the nights for Clint Capella where his teammates actually try to get him more involved than they normally do.
And Philadelphia calls time here. With some changes, there's a check in for PJ Tucker. Shake Milton comes in for Matisse Thybul, and it's Quirkmaz in for Maxi. Picking him up. Here's Murray. Harden grabs the miss.
Well, he wants to shoot his way out of his cold spell, but the struggles continue. Yeah, he's got to move on, forget about this sequence here, and try to find a way to get on the board.
Here's Quirkmaz. Five on the clock. Will it go? Rebound Atlanta.
And they just can't find a way to end this thing. Nothing's wrong. Frustration seems to be mounting here, and you can see not just in their faces, but right now in their and hurry shot selection.
Now, here is Young. 6 points for him. Here's Capella, and it's tonight. And as it goes out of bounds, Atlanta able to keep the ball here. And we gotta take a second look to admire that outstanding block.
And guys, that block could really help change the momentum of this game.
Frank Kaminsky, he's checked in for the Hawks.
Frank Kaminsky, the third.
and the clock. And once again off the mark by Atlanta, the 76ers trail by 12. And with it, now guarded by Kaminsky, there is good.
Tobias Harris showing a little floater for that time.
And that outstanding drive and finish brought to you by Mobile One.
And a bucket like that one might be just what they need to cut into this lead.
Here's the Hawks with the ball. They're on a 14-6 run. Now here's Murray. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet. Here's O'Connor. And there's the bucket, stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done.
And the rebound and the foul show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with the soft touch to match.
Here's Court Bonds, hunting outside. And he gets the whistle for the 3-second clock.
Just a deflating arrow on his part. Yeah, he knows he shouldn't have made it, and that's just really overall a frustrating sequence that hopefully doesn't stick with him.
Anthony Melton, he's jugged in for the 76ers. Now, here is Young. 6 points for him.
Grabs the board. He told me this was the kind of game he was going to have. I would not have expected that to be in front right now.
And the way Trae Young GA is the focus of this offense, the numbers just pile up.
Yeah, I mean, they run so much through him. His usage rate is off the charts. Led the entire league in total points and total assists in 2022. And that hadn't been done in 49 years.
And he can't get the first one. The second free throw, good. And the Hawks with possession here. And here's Atlanta. They're on a 16-7 run. Unloads from 13. Young, no good. The 76ers trail by 11. Milton, who's averaging around 5.5 points a game. And the basket by Harris.
Yeah, here's a list of things I don't want to do, and right at the top is guard that down.
Young pass to Kaminsky. Defended by Milton. Atlanta again, missing.
Hard to figure out. No defender inside.
Milton with the ball. It's Jackson picking him up. Milton passes to Harris.
a more deadly backcourt in the East.
First one drops,
and it's the growth of Murray as a distributor has really proved to be a great point guard. There were questions about that early in his career.
And Greg, you can see it, Murray has really improved his passing.
He has a great sense of the court and spacing, reads defense as well, and can direct his teammates. Puts him in being an elite passer in no time.
Now here's Milton, the pass to Masson. A nice ball movement here by the 76ers. He lines it up, and he hits it just before the shot clock expires.
And hard to decide which is better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
Well, there's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. Here's Murray, looking at the numbers, he's averaging about 20.5 points a game. Here's Young, and that one goes out.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing. Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
Harris's shot is off. The Hawks leading by 7. Floats it up for Murray. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
I'm all for the crowd interacting with the players, but not so much the players interacting with the crowd. That one, errant pass.
There's 10 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Bounce pass for Milton. Here's Harris. The clock runs out and we're heading to halftime. Hawks on top. They're up by 7. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Trey, you've made it look easy so far. How have you been able to pick them apart?
I'm just taking what the defense is giving me. Open driving lanes. They're leaving some of our bids open. Pick and rolls, things like that. We just got to continue to do it and try to get the win.
Make them pick their poison, right? Thanks for your time, man. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Remix. Greetings, everybody. We love exciting. And this game is delivered, as we've seen two top players battling mano a mano. A couple of guys locking horns tonight. Neither one of them backing down, as you would expect. You can tell both teams are giving these guys space to work. And they're taking advantage of the opportunities. Well, let's turn now to our current game. And I tell you what, how about Clint Capela in the first half? Even if the defense doubles him, I don't think it's slowing him down, Ernie. This guy's locked in. This is the most locked in I've ever seen him. No, I agree. Explosive performance. This is what fans pay to see. And that's a halftime wrap. Let's get back to the second half with the call by Kevin Harlan and the crew. The second half of this game still to play. And so it's Maxey who brings up the ball for the 76ers. Front court is Stiebel and Harris. Harden out there with Tyrese Maxey. And it's Bossy in at the five. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. Now here's Murray. After the miss from Tyrese Maxey. Harden against Young. Passes it to Collins. The basket good off the assist from Young. Young's got his fourth assist in this one. Harden outside. With three, Harris traps in the tray. Harris has got 12 in the game.
But early in his career, defense is challenged Tobias Harris to take this shot. They don't want him to, for good reason.
Now, here's Collins. And it's blocked, and they'll keep possession. Just five to shoot. No. Shooting foul. He has the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. It's going to be on James Harden.
That's the attitude that the coaching staff talked to us about before the game. Heads up, aggressive play right at whoever's guarding Trae Young.
Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for Young.
Fair or not, as long as Trae Young is in the NBA, he will be connected to Luka Doncic. And that night back in 2018 during the draft, where those two guys swapped teams.
Both shots good from the strike.
In that 2018 draft, Brent, the Doncic Young swap was a huge deal.
Yeah, so the two will be compared, and I think that's been a great deal for each team. You've seen the growth, you've seen them in the playoffs, you've seen the kind of excitement level that they brought to the fans, and both have been all-stars. So you can play both spectacular offensive players, and they both are carrying the load. Tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
On the night, he's gone 2-for-2 at the stripe.
And up to this point on the season, he's set a pace of right around 73% when he gets the line.
Shooting two.
And he knocks down the first one.
From the line this time, here's Maxey. 9 points in the game so far.
First minute and a half of basketball here in the third quarter.
Harden should be in the game.
Sends it back.
Capella, one of the best shot blockers in the NBA. You can see his timing on that play.
Hunter pushes the arm. It's Collins a screen on Maxey. Dunk pass to Collins. It's good.
Collins has got the lead up to 12 now for the Hawks.
I'm willing to let up even for a moment. That's his killer instinct. Just fanning the flame. And he's the guy that you want to go to right now trying to put this one away.
Here's his shot is good.
Such a smooth score. Tobias Harris making that look easy.
Murray, the pass to Capella. Collins, a screen on Maxey. Murray, this is to Collins. That's in there. Murray with the assist. 14 points for John Collins.
They're doing work here in the second half. 3 or 4 to start.
Master Harden. The 17-footer.
Here's Bassett.
And that one is hammered home.
We have to prevent him from getting to the paint. Unless you want to see a highlight.
The pass to Collins. And that one drops. Murray's got 6 points.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
Okay. Kleba. Defense right on him. Here's Harden. And Capella sends it back. And now we've got some time to check in from the sidelines. You got for us, DA?
Thanks, guys. Now we see more and more top prospects bypass college or even leave high school early to make six figures playing for G League at night. Many years going pro at such a young age was something we only saw abroad. That reality is now here. Kevin?
I like it too, David. The landscape is shifting, and I think for the better. Thank you for the report. Now here is Harris. After the miss from John Collins.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Capella with a screen on Hart. And Young picks to Hunter. Collins looking around. And a deep three from Young. He's off on that one. And Philadelphia the other way now. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Bounce pass Maxey. Fibel, the pass to Harris.
Over Miller.
Another miss by Philadelphia. The Hawks leading by 11. Dishes it to Young. Back to Murray. There's the triple. Sinks the triple. Murray's got 9 points.
He's gonna punish you if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
Harden kicks to Maxey. Pass to Bassey. And he drops in the layup off the glass. 6 points for him.
And that tells the tale here today, guys. Throughout this game, we've been able to get the ball in tight and finish.
Atlanta calls timeout. And Brent, nowadays, there are so many options for the great high school basketball player in this country and overseas. Do you see the G League Ignite in similar ways as a positive overall?
Well, I think right now you'd have to say that the G League Ignite has been a successful experiment, and that run is going to continue. Get guys like Jalen Green, drafted by the Houston Rockets and came in, had a sensational rookie season. That pathway has led him there, so I think they're doing a good job. The interesting thing, Kevin, to talk about is what colleges have done in response to that and what's going on in the NIL space. How does that change the dynamic in the future?
checked in for the 76ers. The Hawks making a switch here. Also good, so he hits both free throws.
And they're doing a better job of working themselves to the line here in the second half.
Maxi passes to Harris. Misses the three.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And Holiday, here we go, over Maxi. Atlanta again missing. The 76ers trail by 14. Pass to Harris. Outside Maxi. Can't connect from 13 feet up. And here's Young. He'll bring it up for Atlanta. They get to take on the Magic in Orlando after this one. That'll be the second of this two-game road trip. Kaminsky sets the pick for Holiday. And once again off the mark by Atlanta. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time
without a bucket. No good. The Hawks win by 14. Outside Holiday. There's the pass to Kaminsky. Here's Silver. Outside Holiday, six on the shot clock. Leans from outside, and once again off the mark by Atlanta.
The next time you should do a better job, I think, of getting balance and set up his feet. That just throws your body way out of whack and hurts your percentages.
Now, Oh, here's Melton. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game. That's the free fly. Atlanta with the rebound. Young's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Picks it off the glass. Young's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And those are the kinds of plays that are just killing them right now.
And that was another look at the fantastic Mobile One drive that happened a moment ago.
And putting that pressure on the rim, that's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Now, here's Maxie. He's got 9. That's right, Harris. And Trey Young gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game. And some changes here for the 76ers. Korkmaz comes in for Matisse Thybulle. And it's Shake Milton in for Maxie. Johnson is checked in for Atlanta. Here's Milton. Here's Korkmaz. Here's Harris. 5 to shoot. Another miss, and they desperately need a bucket.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Johnson dishes to Young. Inside. Kaminsky, and finished off by Kaminsky.
That's what he gives you, a big-time presence on the glass.
And you know what, Greg? Once he gets his hands on it, he's not even thinking about kicking it out.
Well, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
And here are the 76ers now. After the basket by Atlanta, here's Korkmaz. Another miss by Philadelphia. The Hawks lead by 18. Holiday, 5 points in the game. Johnson sets the screen for Holiday. Number 3 off target. Philadelphia has gone into the 3-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. Korkmaz kicks to Milton. Now the feed to Harris. And slam dunk by Harris.
That's a strong finish from Tobias Harris.
For Atlanta, they've gone 7 of 15 from the field here in the third quarter. Passes to Young. Kaminsky with the ball. Guarded by Tucker. Kaminsky the pass to Young. Great pass to set up the lay-in. Young's got 12.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the lane.
Milton with it. Here's Harris. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line. Harris has got 10 points in just the second half.
Great quarter for this happy offensive man trying to heal his team back in the game.
Kaminsky sets the pick for Young. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot. The 76ers trail by 16. And the final ball. They say it was last touch by Kaminsky. Ogunwu's checked in for the... DeAndre Hunter comes in for Johnson. .153 left here in the third quarter. Pass to Tucker. Back to Milton. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Yeah, good job to take it right at him.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
And with an 86% free throw average, you can count on him to come through on most trips.
First one falls for. Free throw is good for Milton. Atlanta leading by 14. And Young kicks to Kaminsky. Holiday dishes to Young. With Samark, Kaminsky. And the shot is good. 8 points for Frank Kaminsky.
To see there just the threat of Young pulling up, it's going to open up the two-man game. The defender forced to come out and respect the deep shot. And Trey able to make the strike.
And it's sent back by Okongwu. There's the pick. Shot clock at 5. A shot by Milton, no good. Atlanta's gone into a slump here from 3-point range, shooting just 1 of 5 here in the third. A floater, and it's laid up and in by Young. Young's got 8 here in the quarter.
That is a tough, tough shot there. Trey Young, such a small player, he needs that floater in his arsenal.
.44 seconds left to play in the third. Milton passes to Tucker. It's Court Bonds. Pass to Milton over Young. The 76ers with another miss. And so Holiday will bring it up for Atlanta. 18 points separating the teams. That's the biggest lead of the game. Philadelphia's gone into the three-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. Now here is Harris, T right on him. Point range, and the last second attempt is not going for it. Trey Young, he's feeling it tonight, has been the driving force for Atlanta. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. And we'll be back with you shortly. And or the candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery.
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
Quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. The Hawks leading by 18. Fourth quarter on the court for the Hawks. Lurie is the shooting guard. Hunter the small forward. John Collins is out there with Okongwu. And it's Holiday in at the point. Now, here's Hunter. Now the pass to Holiday. Kicks it out to Collins. Stolen by Tucker. Passes it to Fiber. Here's Bassett. Harden outside. Let's find the shoot. Clock up two there.
And inside hard is such a difficult cover. Get too close, and you know you'll cleverly draw a foul.
Astro Conwood. And out it takes to Murray. To the paint, Okongwu, the pass to Collins. Harden against Holiday. The Hawks need to get off a shot here. Collins, good.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Outside, Maxi. Harden outside. From outside, off the mark.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is gonna be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
Now here's Murray. And again, it's Atlanta.
And yeah, he's not messing around. He wants no part of a comeback in this one.
Well, he's grabbed a tee and a blanket because he's putting this one to bed.
Harden against Holiday. Harden sets the pick for Maxi. Pass to Fiber. We're seeing a lot of pretty lively pregame dance routines from the players. You got any of that in your repertoire, say, before we begin a broadcast?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think pretty soon we should work out a few sequences.
You know, get ourselves fired up.
You get
it? Come on, Greg, I'm not sure about that, but you go ahead and do it.
Solid night so far, confidence rising in this game.
And Philadelphia calls time here. And guys, how about the different ways John Collins can score on you?
Well, John Collins can bully you on the inside, or he can spot up and shoot a little bit from the three-point line. So that ability to stretch the floor makes him one of the harder forwards to have to contend with. Thank you.
player of the game, John Collins.
And his percentage from the field tonight seemed almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
And then we're in danger of losing back-to-back games before he stepped to the forefront here tonight. This was not a game he was going to let get away from him. At that powerful rejection.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
Hey. Six to shoot. Harden the pass to Harris. Over Collins.
He's very engaged right now, John Collins, defensively, and that's starting to make a difference for the team. And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
And Murray, here we go. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Murray's got 11 in the second half. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Harris misses.
That's another just bad decision on a night full of those. His shot selection tonight has been questionable at best.
Collins, a screen on Hart. Young fires away from outside. Here's Murray. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
That's his first personal foul. First team foul. At the line for the Hawks, DeJounte Murray. At the line for two,
shoot two.
He misses the free throw, and even with the ratings going strong, the younger generation's often cord cutting. How does the NBA engage that audience?
Kevin, I think making game action trend on social media, and when big moments happen for maybe a small fee, allow people to be a part of it. It's like highlights, but live.
And he can't make the second free throw either. Missing both. For Philadelphia, they've gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Harris passes to Bassett. Theibel. Out left to the wing. Takes the three. Another miss by Philadelphia.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Jan finds Capella. Young against Harden. And here's Collins from outside. And we'll get another chance. Count that bucket.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Philadelphia's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Harris passes to Maxey. The pass to Harden. Another miss by Philadelphia.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage. Yeah, just nice strength there and then just off with the shot.
At the line for Philadelphia, Charles Bassey taking two shots.
First free throw is good. Rumors continue to fly about possible league expansion. Brent, any cities you'd like to see join the league?
Oh man, there's a lot of great options out there, Kevin, but I would like to see the league go to 32 and have 16 in each conference. I think that would be great. And there's a city in the Pacific Northwest that deserves a team, and I think you know where I'm talking about. Seattle.
And so it's both.
This is as good as it gets from the charity strike here in the second.
Now, here is Young. Inside, here's Collins. And finish off by Collins.
Like it when Collins is cleaning up the glass and then just rocking the rim.
And here's Harden. A screen on Young. And with it, he's picked up by Collins. From deep. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. And now, a chance to see what's coming up for the Philadelphia 76ers. On Wednesday, they'll face off against Donovan Mitchell and the Cleveland Cavaliers. And then on Friday, they'll be facing Steven Adams and the Memphis Grizzlies.
And they are looking at a ton of road games in the next stretch, but this team shouldn't fear the idea of it. They've been more than capable of getting wins on the road, and I wouldn't expect anything less on this trip. You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Theibel kicks to Maxey. Passes it to Harden. Lets it go from deep. And it's John Collins with the rebound. Collins has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Young from outside gets the three-pointer to fall.
There is an effortless kind of motion to what Trae Young can do, especially when he's shooting from that deep.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Maxi passes to Bassett. Harden outside. Another miss by Philadelphia.
Wow, what a rough second half for him shooting the basketball. Maybe you adopt a pass-first mentality at this point.
And the dunk by Capella.
Capella is in a great system here. He's a rebounder, he's a shot blocker, he can run the floor. And he takes a lot of shots he knows he can make.
Now here is Harris. To the inside. Here's Bassett. The basket is good. The assist from Harris. And he's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense. A quick move to the bucket. And you get the lay-in.
And finish off by Collins.
And how sweet a play was that?
As sweet as it gets, an exquisite pass to set up the powerful alley-oop dunk. Now here is Harris. Here's Maxey. Harden outside, looking to get back on track here, and he knocks down the jumper.
And as they're trailing in this game, that they're trying to stay in it with the triples. They're shooting a lot more of them than they did in the first half.
Here's Hunter. Pass to Young. This one for three. Rebound by the 76ers. Harris has got 6 rebounds now in the game. Feibel, the pass to Harris. Last season, of course, Marcus Smart, the Defensive Player of the Year. You know, Greg, it's rare to see a guard win it. Should perimeter players get more consideration from this point on?
It's tough, Dev. I do think they should. I think the numbers, though, tend to favor the rim protectors, but it's only right to recognize great defense at every position, especially in an age of positionless basketball.
Here's Young after the Sixers pick up two. Second shot opportunity. He takes it up and lays it in. Capella's got 6 points in the quarter.
Capella, one of the best offensive rebounders in the league. It's because of his activity.
Maxey passes to Harris. From 12 feet out. Here's Bassett. Again with the block.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. Murray dishes to Young. Collins a screen on Harden. Again, Young missing.
You know, he's usually very reliable from out there, but tonight it's just not going down.
Pass to Harden for the three. The three-pointers right on target.
Well, the defense very attentive to him in the first quarter, but he's finally gotten loose in the second and making them pay.
Now Young. Collins a screen on Harden. Young drives in. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one on Harris.
Well, the speed that Trae Young has is a problem for a lot of guys who are trying to defend him. They're compromised if he comes at them.
Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw good from Young. Greg, you read about Jimmy Butler starting his own coffee company, and he did that in the NBA bubble, and he drinks, he said, about 5 cups of coffee a day. Do a lot of NBA players drink coffee to keep them going and get that extra burst?
Absolutely. I remember drinking coffee on the bench late in my career. It's kind of a comfort food, warms you up a little bit. All good things that can get you ready for action, I'm for.
Now it's Harden. Milton with it. Here's Court Miles. His three-pointers off the mark. Here's Murray. Here's Young. Into the lane. That's in there. Murray with the assist. Murray's got assist number 5 here tonight. The 76ers shooting just 33%, struggling to get good looks. We've got 1:55 left in the fourth quarter. There's the pick. There's Cortez. Makes the first. And for a while there, Greg, it seemed like we were entering the super team era. But lately, homegrown talent, players you draft and develop or sign and develop, seems to be the way teams are going.
Yeah, and it's not easy to maintain a culture when you're bringing in stars from outside. We've seen some cautionary examples here of late.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. One 46 left in the fourth quarter of this one. holiday that passed to silver. Not the holiday. Capella at the elbow. The pass to silver. Shot clock at 6. Offensive rebound. Through the net again. He's done that 10 times tonight. And he's only needed 11 shots to get there.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout. Big time dominance. And this will go in the record books as a galley win for Atlanta.
Starting 5 must have been happy to get so much help from the reserves in this game.
And they not only liked the load, the subs did nothing less than guarantee a win.
And this will be a big win for them. Lucky win number 13 now in the bag.
Really a big time win for these guys. They lost their first 2 games of the year to this team, so they won't be in danger of getting swept when they meet for the 4th time.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Clint Capella.
I just loved his defense. He took pride in swatting away a bunch of shots tonight and made his impact felt.
Here's Tucker, following the basket by Trae Young. This is it to Milton. Oh, good on the 3. We've got 33 seconds left in the 4th quarter. Young against Harden. Johnson sends the screen for Young. And there's the drive over Harden. Harden with the defensive effort. And so Harden will bring it up for the 76ers. Building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need homework in Smithfield at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you very much, guys. Trey, what does a win like this mean in terms of where this team is heading?
I think we're headed in the right direction. I'm super excited about the future here in Atlanta, the future of this team, and we're headed in the right direction.
Certainly looks like it, man. Thanks very much. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. We'll see you later.